In Galatians chapter 2, verse 21 says, if righteousness could come through following the Torah, then Christ died in vain. As far as Paul is concerned, it is not possible to follow the law. Well, what do we know from the Torah? We know from the Torah that we can keep it. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 11 through 14, it says, now what I am commanding you today, this is Moses speaking, is not too difficult for you or beyond your reach. No, the word is very near to you. It is in your mouth and in your heart that you may do it.
It is absurd to think that God would give a Torah that was impossible or too difficult to follow. In many places, the Bible says that the Torah was given forever. It is therefore impossible to say that it has been replaced by a new law or testament.
What does the Tanakh, the Jewish Bible, say about our obligation to keep the commandments? So you shall keep his statutes and his commandments, which I am giving you today, that it may go well with you and with your children after you, that you may live long on the land which the Lord your God is giving you for all time. How long do we have to keep God's commandments? Saying here basically forever. Deuteronomy 12:1. These are the statutes and the judgments which you shall carefully observe in the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, has given you to possess as long as you live on the earth. 2 Kings 17. And the statutes and the ordinances and the law and the commandment which he wrote for you, you shall observe to do forever. Right? We would say to Paul, read my lips. What word don't you understand?
The Sabbath is an everlasting covenant with all its laws. The Bible says the Jewish people shall keep the Sabbath, to do the Sabbath for all their generations, an everlasting covenant. When was the Sabbath when Christianity started? On Saturday. A few hundred years later, they decided that was too Jewish and they changed it to Sunday. How can you change God's Sabbath from one day to another? How can you do that? And what they call the Trinity is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And even though the scriptures say that God is one, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is only one. But somehow, 3 equals 1, 1 equals 3.
Christians claim that this three-part God that they worship is the same as the God worshipped by the Jews. This is not true. The Bible states, hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord is one.